buckle up, because this is going to be huge for you. No, I mean it. This one is actually a game changer. ChatGPT is a true superpower when it comes to writing. And getting started and using it as your assistant writer is not very hard. But there's several hidden prompts and formulas that you really need to know about to get the most out of it. And at the end of the day, if you're using ChatGPT, you already have a competitive advantage. But even within that, this content will give you another advantage over all the typical
"I'm a large language model"
answer receivers. And first, I want to begin with a use case that you've probably already seen, and that's asking to write an essay. But I need you to start thinking differently about this, because this is what ChatGPT really sees in the background. And if you see the formula written out like this, it allows you to craft prompts that are completely unique to you. And then you can start expanding it with building blocks like "in the style of," and then you insert the style. And this is really the key to becoming a little more advanced here. Okay, and here a quick tip on a few things you could insert instead of the variables. Instead of essay, you could say poem, blog article, or song. And instead of Hemingway, you could pretty much pick most public personalities that have published a large body of work. This could range all the way from philosophers and religious figures to comedians like Dave Chappelle. Okay, now that you understand the basic writing prompt, I want to show you some tricks and keywords that will help you to get the most out of your writing. I'll just pick the first paragraph in Wikipedia of my favorite artist, and we'll use some of these keywords here. So when I insert it into ChatGPT and put it into quotation marks, one fantastic keyword here is rephrase. What that will do is express the same ideas in a different tone. Now, yes, this could easily be abused to plagiarize, but I'm not here to judge the ethical implications. I'm simply showing what is possible with this technology. And as you can see here, it turns the Wikipedia article into an almost original piece of text. Kind of. And if I use a basic plagiarism checker and first check for the Wikipedia article and then for the ChatGPT output after I rephrased it, this is what I get. The Wikipedia article is 80% plagiarized, obviously. Actually, kind of surprising that it's not 100, right? And as you can see, the ChatGPT output gets a 100% unique rating. Now, look, I'm fully aware that universities have more complex plagiarism checkers, but the point is that the keyword rephrase is pretty damn powerful. Okay, so the next super powerful prompt right here focuses on a different aspect of writing. A lot of times when you write, you first have to research. And in order to research, you need to absorb information. And if you do your work well, you absorb a lot of information, like a book. That would also be a typical school assignment, wouldn't it? I could just go ahead and say, provide me with an outline for the book The Old Man and the Sea. By the way, I read that and so should you. Incredible book. But let's see what ChatGPT can do here. Excellent work, honestly. So as you can see, provide me with an outline is an extremely powerful prompt, because you could run this on books, articles, or even transcripts that you feed it yourself. And you can always go in and say, elaborate on a second point. Santiago sets out to sea early one morning, hoping to catch a big fish and end his streak of 84 days without a catch. And then in the end, overall, Santiago's struggle with the fish serves as a metaphor for the human struggle to overcome challenges and persevere in the face of adversity. Legendary story worth reading, but also a very useful prompt. Okay, so here's one that you could totally use for learning purposes when working with a young person. Let's say they write a text and they use pretty basic vocabulary. Yesterday I went to school. It was really fun. Me and my friends had lunch and then we played cards. Now, instead of explaining to that person, hey, maybe you could string these together, or maybe you could use more advanced words or adjectives, simply put this in quotation marks and tell ChatGPT the following. Replace my simple vocabulary with advanced English. Yesterday I visited school. The experience was quite enjoyable. My friends and I shared a meal together and afterwards engaged in a game of cards. And honestly, using a tool like this is one of the better ways to communicate with a human being. You can take input that they generated and show them instantly how else this could be approached. And as per usual, you can follow up with, now write it in the style of a video game dialogue, and instantly it picks a tone of voice that resonates with young people. If you appreciate this content, hit that like button for me. But now let's move on to the next point. All right, and here's my last one, and buckle up, because this is going to be huge for you. No, I mean it. This one is actually a game changer. Act as a professional spelling and grammar corrector and improver. Sure, I'd be happy to help. Please provide the text. And now we'll completely butcher this and see what it can do, okay? Okay, let's just submit this and see what we get. That is perfect. And here's one bonus tip. Now write that in the style of a Pulitzer Prize winner. If you didn't know, Pulitzer Prizes are literary Oscars.
Greetings, dear sir or madam. As a connoisseur of the English language, I find myself in need of a refreshing beverage. And what could be more fitting than a classic Coca-Cola?
Pretty cool. And as previously mentioned, you can think about these in terms of formulas. So really, I just gave you the secret sauce to so many functions, if you think about it. Because act as a professional spelling and grammar corrector and improver can be seen as act as a professional, insert profession. Now you pick, and right away you can start talking to a psychologist or electrician. And trust me, you'll be surprised by how professional and educated they actually are. All right, so what all these had in common is that they took a different approach to communicating with the AI. And that's really the key here. The data set that this has been trained by is in certain ways superior to what humans can know. But then there's other things we do way better. But by knowing some of these tips and tricks, you can really combine the best of both worlds, your intuition, emotional intelligence, and knowledge with the AI's data. And that's the whole point of this channel. But in this video, I was only able to show you 5 prompts. But the truth of the matter is there is so much more. And I decided to start a weekly newsletter featuring the best and most innovative prompts so you can get the maximum out of this revolutionary technology. It's completely free, and trust me, I'll make sure it's the opposite of spam. Meanwhile, here's a video with even more creative prompts, and as per usual, put these to work responsibly.